Hello, I'm Amara Jones, and today is Friday, January 23rd. This is caffeineTV, your daily news brief, here to take you through three headline numbers in just 3 minutes, giving you a different take on everything from housing policy to the Real Housewives. The first number up today is 20, as in 20%. That's how much of the world's proven oil reserves rest in the conservative, authoritarian Persian Gulf state of Saudi Arabia. And yesterday, Saudi Arabia was rocked by the death of its 90-year-old king, Abdullah. His 79-year-old brother, Crown Prince Sulman, will become king. I guess you have to be over 75 to sit on the throne. Well, during his 20 years of power, King Abdullah was a staunch ally of the United States, but he was also at the heart of the conservative backlash against the Democratic Arab Spring movement, helping to keep and put in place strongmen across the region. And he also backed jihadi rebels in the Syrian civil war in their fight against dictator Bashar al-Assad. But perhaps the greatest challenges that he faced and that his brother will face are the calls for change at home. Women can serve in the Saudi government, but they can't drive. And we spoke about last week the case of Raif Badawi, who was sentenced to 1,000-lash sentence, along with other harsh penalties for writing for more openness in that kingdom. And so, with already things in the Middle East being turned upside down, the death of King Abdullah only adds to the turmoil. The next number up today is 12. That's the jersey number for New England Patriots quarterback Tom Brady, who yesterday took to the podium to give his response to DeflateGate, the fact that the Patriots played their AFC championship with 11 deflated balls, giving them an unfair advantage. And he basically said that he was shocked that all the balls felt the same and that don't ask him anything because he just works there. Now, he just echoed the sentiments of Bill Belichick, the coach of the team, who said basically the same thing earlier in the day. So when it comes to the Patriots, the coach doesn't know about the team and the quarterback doesn't know about balls. Well, basically after Brady's comments, a whole slew of former players took to basically every single sports network that you can think of to shout him down. Super Bowl ring wearer Mark Brunell on ESPN said that it was unthinkable that an equipment manager would change the balls without consulting with the quarterback. Hall of Famer Troy Aikman basically said the same, and Amani Toomer on Pro Football Now caught both the regulation ball and the ball that the Patriots played with and said that the difference between the two was the difference between a real football and a Nerf football. Well, it seems like in this case someone is lying, and with the string of bungled NFL investigations recently, good luck to Roger Goodell and figuring out who that is. The last number up today is $585,655, as in dollars. That's how much the family of Iowa Senator Joni Ernst received in government contracts and subsidies throughout the years. That was revealed yesterday by Forbes magazine. Now, earlier this week, Senator Ernst gave the Republican response to President Obama's State of the Union address, in which he said that the country didn't need any of what he was advocating for the middle class, like free community college or better help with overtime work. She said that what we needed was less government and more workers, hard work. She gave the example of herself plowing fields in Iowa and baking biscuits at Hardee's, and said that her mom put bread bags over her shoes to preserve them because they were her only pair. Now, at that time, the internet then went straight ham on the idea of bread shoes. My favorite is the tweet which said that Nike was going to start a line called Air Ernst, and it showed someone with their feet in a bread loaf as sneakers. Now, what's interesting is that last year, Senator Ernst was elected on the idea that she was going to go to Washington to trim the pork. She said that growing up in Iowa, castrating pigs gave her a great idea for how to trim the fat, but all these revelations show is that all along she's been feeding at the trough.